Hello students, now I'm going to start question number 3 of exercise 4.3. Now question number 3 says solve the following equation. So here we will have to find the value of the variable. Okay, so p, t, m, whatever we have, we will just find the value of the variable here. Now in the first part we have 4 is equals to 5 multiplied by p minus 2. Now this binomial is multiplied by 5. So, at first, 4 will remain same. We will just multiply it by 5 to p and 2. That means the one which is given outside of the bracket, that number will be multiplied by all the terms which is inside of the bracket. So, 5 multiplied by p is 5p minus 5 multiplied by 2 is 10. Now, since we will have to find the value of the variable which is p, so here, we will not take this one on left hand side. So here we have two function. At first we have minus sign and here we have multiplication. So that means at first we will just remove 10 from p, right? So on the left hand side we have 4, and if you take 10 on the left hand side, so minus 10 will be plus 10, and on the right hand side we have 5p. Okay, because as you know that if while solving the equation, we first remove plus or minus whatever we have and then we do multiplication or divide. Okay, so here since this is having negative sign, so at first we remove 10, and since this is given in multiplication forms, then we will remove that. Okay, so here 4 plus 10 is 14 and is equals to 5p. Now 5 is multiplied by p. Now if you remove 5, if you transpose 5 to left hand side, it will be 14 divided by 5. So the value of p is 14 by 5. Okay, now coming to next part. Now in the next part we have minus 4 is equals to 5 multiplied by p minus 2. So again minus 4 will remain same. We'll just multiply by 5 to this binomial. Now always remember, the one which is outside of the bracket, that number will be multiplied by all the terms inside of the bracket. Like here we have two terms, so 5 will be multiplied by p, so it's 5p. Then we have minus sign and then 5 multiplied by 2, so it's 5 into 2, 10. So again we have two function here. One is this minus and here we have multiplication. So at first we will remove 10, so minus 4 on the left hand side we have, and we will take minus 10 on the left hand side, so it will become plus 10, and on the right hand side we have 5p. Now here plus minus minus, so 10 minus 4 is 6, and since 10 is having plus sign and 10 is greater than 4, so the sign of 6 will be positive, so 6 is equals to 5p. Now 5p means 5 is multiplied by p, so what will be the value of p? It will be 6 by 5, because if we take 5 on the left hand side, it will be division, right? So the value of p will be 6 by 5. Okay, now coming to next part. Now in the c part we have 16 is equals to 4 plus 3 multiplied by this binomial. So here 16 will remain same on the left hand side. Then we have 4 plus 3 multiplied by t is 3t plus 3 multiplied by 2 is 6. Now 16 equal to, now see this 4 and 6, these two are constant, these are like term, so we can add these two. So 6 plus 4 is 10 plus 3t. Now again we have two function, one is positive and one is multiplication. So here, see here is addition and multiplication. So at first we will have to remove 10. So 16 is there on the left hand side. So if you transpose 10 on the left hand side, so it will be minus 10, which is equals to 3t. Now 16 minus 10 is 6, is equals to 3t. Now 3 is multiplied by t. So to find the value of the variable which is t, you will have to transpose 3 to the left hand side, so it will be 6 divided by 3, right? So 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6, so the value of the variable which is t here is 2. Okay, now next part. Now in the next part we have 4 plus 5 multiplied by p minus 1 is equals to 34. So this is same as the previous one. We'll just keep 4 as it is. Then we have plus sign. Now 5 multiplied by p is 5p minus 5 multiplied by 1 is 5 is equals to 34. Now this 4 and 5 is like term. So if you put together 4 minus 5 plus 5p is equals to 34. Now see, here is plus, this is plus and this is minus. So plus minus minus, so 5 minus 4 is how much? It's 1. But what will be the sign here? Since 5 is greater than 4 and the sign of 5 is negative, so it will be minus 1. So minus 1 plus 5p is equals to 34. Now again we have two functions. One is this, okay, and another is this. Means one is addition, here we have multiplication, sorry, here we have subtraction and here we have multiplication. So at first we will remove 1. So 5p will remain same on the left hand side. So on the right hand side we have 34. So if you transpose 1 to another side, it will be plus 1. So 5p is equals to 34 plus 1 is 35. So what will be the value of p? It's 35 by 5, means 35 will be divided by 5 because it is given in multiplication form. So 5 ones are 5, 5 sevens are 35. So the value of p is 7. Okay, now coming to last part. Now in the last part we have 0 is equals to 16 plus 4 into m minus 6. So we are finding the value of m here. So at first we have to remove 16 because 16 is outside of the bracket. 4 is also outside of the bracket, but 4 is in multiplication form. 4 is multiplied by this binomial, right? So one by one we will have to remove. So at first we are removing 16. So 16, if you transpose to left hand side, it will be minus 16 is equals to 4 multiplied by m minus 6. Now 4 multiplied by m is 4m, so minus 16 will remain same on the left hand side. So on the right hand side we have 4m minus 4 into 6 is 24. Now here again we have two functions. One is this subtraction, one is multiplication. So we will have to remove 24 at first. So on the left hand side we have minus 16. If you transpose 24 on the left hand side, minus 24 will be plus 24 is equals to 4m. Now plus minus minus, so 24 minus 16 is 8, and since sign of 24 is greater, so since 24 is greater and 24 is having plus sign, so 8 will be positive. So 8 is equals to 4m. Now 4m means 4 is multiplied by m. So what will be the value of m? It will be 8 divided by 4. If you transpose 4 to left hand side, it will be division. Now 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. So what will be the value of m? It's 2 by 1, which is 2. Okay, so this was the last part of number 3. Thank you, students.